Hey everyone, my name is Savannah, and yesterday we got a brand new dev diary for August for Prehistoric Kingdom, and we've got some good stuff to talk about. So let's jump right in. In this blog post, the team will be sharing some exciting announcements as well as providing more progress on both Update 8 and Update 9. First off, we have artbook and mini OST announcement. So the digital artbook and mini soundtrack are launching after Update 8. And I love this. A soundtrack is not something that's very new to games. Usually games will release a soundtrack alongside their game, but the artwork is fantastic. That's right, a digital art book and mini soundtrack will be released on Steam later this year to coincide with one of our next major updates. Whether you'd like to appreciate the work of our artists or listen to some Jurassic jams, we've got you covered. The Art of Prehistoric Kingdom. Over 100 pages of concept art and insight to the development process, exploring not just the animals, but guests, structures, and more. Includes artist interviews, notes, and exclusive artwork. I think this is phenomenal. This is so cool to get a kind of in-depth and behind the scenes, a little peek behind the curtain, if you will, at the development of the game. As a huge like collector type person myself, specifically for some of the Nintendo franchises, I'm always buying the artwork books and the behind the scenes stuff like that, because I love so much seeing how these games came to be and the work that these artists put into the models and the development of the game is just phenomenal. So I'm really excited to get my hands on this and see all the artwork that they're going to release and look at all of the animals, because the main reason I play a lot of these games is to look at the animals themselves. And Prehistoric Kingdom, I must say, has some of the most beautiful animal models of any simulation game. And so I'm really excited about this art book. The only thing that would make the collector in me happier is if they released like a hardcover artwork book. Ooh, I'd snap that up in a heartbeat, but I will be happy with the digital version of it as well. A Walk in the Park music from Prehistoric Kingdom is 30 minutes of music from Challenge Mode, the Animal Nursery, and the opening tutorial. 15 tracks, including 4 bonus map medleys, and updated arrangements for challenge mode tracks. Now, as a creator, this is fantastic for me because I love to use the soundtracks from the game in the videos that I create. So I definitely will be utilizing some of that. So I think that that is awesome. Eligible backers and early adopters from both Kickstarter and Creativo will receive Steam keys to redeem their goods once available. Stay tuned for information regarding pricing, keys, and release dates. So awesome! That's the very start of the dev diary, and now we're going to jump into the game itself, where we're at. Before talking about animals, the best part, so stay tuned, and Update 8, let's quickly discuss how things are going. To start, there have been a bunch of under-the-hood improvements to improve the game's stability across the board, with many hopefully going on to address numerous crash reports. Guests have also been further improved since last month, now including a fully complete queuing system and more fluid navigation. This means that your visitors should be less likely to clump up and must patiently wait their turn to use interaction points. Imagine a conveyor belt, but you know, for humans. In basically every area, guests are vastly more robust, and as a result, the economy should be much more stable too. Look at those guests forming a line. You know, it looks like they're also, you know, social distancing, which is great. But that's awesome. Improvements to guests are fantastic. You know, I don't really honestly pay too much attention to them. But when we inevitably do actually play the game as a game instead of, you know, how I'm treating it as just like a build pretty things kind of thing, the guests are going to be important. So quality updates for them, much needed, much appreciated. It might surprise you, but all of this work on guests is actually being done in preparation for staff. We're not quite ready to publicly talk about our plans for staff yet, but from a development perspective, staff are functionally just special guests with some unique abilities and navigation rules. I actually got a question on one of my previous Prehistoric Kingdom videos about staff. So they don't have staff in the game just yet, but as we just read, they are coming, obviously, because you need people to take care of your animals in your animal park. Once the long-awaited animal rework has been released in Update 8, we'll be diving straight into development on staff, including mechanics for one of the game's new central pillars, logistics management. This is an evolution of the produce station gameplay we spoke about in June's Dev Diary, and you can see that video on my channel if you are interested. We cover every single month's Dev Diary, so they're all on the channel if you want to go back and see what else they've announced. Now, better designed to work with staff integration. Please stay tuned for more news on staff over the coming months, but for now, the best part, let's talk about animals. The animal rework has been progressing very well. We made great headway with animals in August and have got them wandering around and recognizing interactables with the new locomotion systems. Animals make choices depending on their internal statistics like stamina, endurance, health, and metabolism. These stats push and pull on an animal's needs, determining when they should rest, find food, and how long their meals will last before they must eat again. Seemingly simple mechanics like this weren't part of the old AI system and will have a huge impact on future features like hunting. I'm so excited for hunting, for breakout, for fighting, for social interactions. I can't wait. Perhaps the biggest downside to all of this AI work is that it's very hard to visualize not only in dev logs, but even while working on it. To help us, we've built robust editor tooling that allows us to more accurately debug and see what animals are doing. This viewer shows a series of tasks animals must complete to accomplish their main goal, shifting columns depending on what has the current priority. A lot of that goes right over my head. I'm not a game developer, programmer, coder, whatever. So there you go. If that makes sense to you, great, awesome. It just sounds like to me they're finding a way to figure out how to best visualize all of the different interactions and the animations and things like that. I'm just, like I said, so excited for animal interactions and just more animations in the game. So I can't wait to see what they're coming up with. Tools like this are crucial as we make animals more reactive and lively. Speaking of, we've been working towards improving how additive and behavioral animations are handled. The goal is to let the AI contextually decide when to play animations so that animals can better express themselves, for example, socializing, becoming angry, resting, rather than relying on simple timers as per the current implementation. On top of this, we're working towards a basic herding implementation that will allow animals to form social groups. Ooh, I'm so excited! Each species has its own natural group sizing, whether that's a large herd, organized pack, or small pairing. The AI will naturally form multiple groups within a habitat if there are too many individuals of a given species, laying the potential foundation for future combat encounters and territorial disputes. This is an area that will definitely be expanding upon down the line once fighting is in. I'm so excited. I can't wait. Prehistoric Kingdom, the developers have done a fantastic job at making these animals, these models, feel so incredibly lifelike and realistic, and just adding interactions amongst themselves with the things in their enclosures is really just going to add to that. So, I mean, I keep saying it, but it's true. I'm so excited to see what these dinosaurs do once we get all those animations. Now, update timeline. In a couple weeks, we should be able to give you a concrete release date for Update 8. Once the system's side of the animal rework has been completed, we will not only need to port the current creatures over, but thoroughly test and ensure they're park ready. After the release of Update 8, we will be able to return to more regular content drops that now add new species, pieces, and maps. There's not much longer to wait. Very exciting. So it sounds like Update 8 obviously is going to be the very big animation overhaul. Lots of kind of stuff that's happening behind the curtain, but making quality of life improvements to the game. And then Update 9 brings us a new species. The park's newest guests will be arriving from the land down under. Can you hear the thunder? Say hello to Muttaburrasaurus? Is that how you say that? You all know, if you're not new here, I'm terrible, so please correct me in the comments down below. In Jurassic World Evolution 2, I was actually calling this the Nuttaburrasaurus, or Nutter Butter, like the candy bar. But anyway, Muttaburrasaurus, I think is how you say that one. And look at how gorgeous he is. This iconic Australian dinosaur lived during the early Cretaceous period, measuring in at around 8 meters long. Despite walking on only two legs, Muttaburrasaurus can be seen adapting a quadrupedal stance while drinking or going to lay down. Look at his snout and his beak. Oh, so, so cool. And look at this one with the white on its face, the blue eyes. Ooh, the leopardy looking spots. That's gorgeous. Like other members of its group, this animal is best characterized by its large protruding nose, giving way to some particularly snuffly vocalizations and snorts. Muttaburrasaurus will be making its way to your parks once Update 9 is released. And also coming in Update 9, check this out. Swimming for the dinosaurs. Along with new species, we've also been hard at work creating animation sets for upcoming swimming behavior. Some animal groups are natural swimmers, graceful and efficient. Others are, well, thankful they haven't drowned yet. Please look forward to seeing animals hit the water in Update 9. That's awesome. So, so cool. And just by the look of these animations here, they look great. Just utilizing the different parts of their body. Obviously, the lower one there kicking with those strong back legs. And then Muttaburrasaurus swimming with all fours. Look at his toes spread on those back feet when he kicks back against the water. Such a little touch, but so realistic. Oh my goodness, I love it so much. And then of course, as always, we have a community spotlight. I'll just kind of go through these real quick because they're always beautiful. Thank you for reading August's Dev Diary. We hope you enjoyed this month's progress update and that you're looking forward to getting a closer look at the art book and soundtrack later this year. As stated, we've expected things to pick up pretty quickly once Update 8 is released. Development has been progressing very well, and we anticipate the announcement of a release date in the next couple weeks. Until next time, the PK team. Very exciting. I love this guy, this new dinosaur. Oh my goodness, he's so pretty, especially this lower picture here. Absolutely gorgeous. Let me know what you think. As always, are you excited? Are there any other dinosaurs that you want to come into the game? What do you think about the animations? What are you hoping for from the animations? Answer all that down in the comment section below. Let's go ahead and have a chat about it until we find out exactly what is coming and when it's coming. And of course, while you're down there, you know, leave a like and subscribe and all that kind of fun YouTube-y stuff, just so you don't miss out on any future Prehistoric Kingdom content. And until next time, thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you in the next video. Bye!